Oh, yes, he swings the lightsabers. That's so amazing. It's so amazing. Hell yeah.
What is up, guys? Meelak here, and today we are back in action playing some Ark Mod. It's going to be freaking amazing. If you guys enjoy, make sure to smash the like button. I'd really appreciate it and help me out tremendously. So, it has been a while since we did modded. Now, the whole thing is I actually recorded this earlier today, and everything screwed up. I recently upgraded to the Windows Anniversary update, and it turned out to be very bad. The update was fine. Nothing else besides that it screwed up my sound. So I all my sounds I recorded for the video was gone, and then the video crashed at the end, so I lost all my progress. So everything just turned out to be bad. Anyways, guys, I just went through, I think like a week ago, I went through, because I tried to record this like a week ago as well. It's been about 2 weeks since the last mod, and I very much apologize for that. It just Scorched Earth came out, and like I really wanted to do Scorched Earth, and I wanted to push Scorched Earth pretty hard, and it was really exciting because all the new creatures and new map and all that kind of stuff. I really just wanted to play Scorched, and now we're back to modded, so modded should be, hopefully, as long as I don't screw everything up, it should be like every other day, something like that. And then we're going to finish up our Scorched Earth series. We always said it was going to be a pretty short series, so that should be ending here pretty soon. And I just went through all the names like a week ago. I went through the names, and I bought like a whiteboard because I'm tired of like, I have like a notebook where I write down stuff for YouTube, and I'm tired of wasting paper. So I got a whiteboard, and I have names. Now, for some reason, I don't know where the dragon is, but we have the wyvern right here, the Bionic Wyvern. And then I think the Giga died last episode, right? So we need to tame a new Giga at some point. But for the wyvern, we got Metro, Felix, and Dactyl, which I thought Dactyl was kind of a cool name. But I think, I don't know, for some reason I like the name Metro just because it reminds me of like a city, which then whenever I think of a city, I think of like technology and metal, and then it makes me think of Bionic and then Metro. That's kind of how I get to that rationale right there. But yeah, there we go. We got Metro for that guy. And then as for the dragon, I'm not sure where the dragon is. Also, we've added a few new mods on the thing here. Let's go ahead and come over here. And let's turn it on. Let's go inside of it. We've added a few new mods. I think we have the, what's this thing called? The Scorched Earth Tabula Rasa mod, which is kind of cool. So I think today we're going to go out, we're going to check out some of the new areas in the center map, and then we're going to look for special, new, amazing Tabula Rasa Scorched Earth creatures. Because I really want to stick a celestial, whatever this is right here, this guy, a lightsaber on a mantis. That would be amazing. And then I want to try out like different creature or different like weapon combinations and stuff like that, and then it's gonna be awesome. Anyways, let's go and summon this guy in right here. Boom. Are you gonna, yeah, there we go. Okay, so we got a Bionic dragon. I'm not sure what happened to the previous one, but I thought I would just summon in a new one here. And then for the dragon, we got several names. We got Merlin, Keros, and then we got Hurricane. Then there were several others as well. I think let's just go ahead and name this guy Hurricane. I don't know why, but I feel like this guy could make a hurricane with his giant wings of amazing like crystalness. So yeah, that's a pretty sweet name. Anyways, I'm not sure what creature we're gonna take out today. Now, whenever I recorded this before, I took out Mars or Bear, but the Bear happened to turned out to be really slow in the water, so it kind of sucked. So I'm gonna try to figure out a creature to bring out, and then I'm gonna meet you guys. I guess exploring. We're gonna go exploring. It's gonna be amazing. I'm not really sure what happened here, but it looks like John Cena like knocked the crap out of Xena here. I'm not sure why is it laying down. Like something knocked it out. There's nothing in the base here. It's like Riot came over and then just straight up passed out one of my creatures randomly, hoping I would log in and see it and like wonder what the heck was going on. We're gonna have to go up to Riot's base and blow it up because I'm sick of his I'm sick of his shit. Okay. I know it wasn't Riot. I just think it's funny blaming Riot. Anyways, I think we're just gonna go ahead. Let's just take out Mars. Let's just do it anyways, because I like Mars. I love dire bears and I miss meaty a lot. So we're gonna just take this guy out. Now I think if we head this way, yeah, if we head over this way. Oh God, am I gonna make it? Am I gonna make it? Am I gonna make it? Nope. No God. Wow. Oh no. Okay, let's just get off this guy. Yeah. So we didn't make it. That's perfectly fine. This turned out to be a horrible idea. We're going ahead to the new area, I think. We're going to head to the new area. This turned out to be bad. In my previous attempt, when I recorded this before, everything worked out all right. So, you know, I was expecting that to happen again, but I guess lightning doesn't strike twice. I'm not sure what this has to do with lightning, but it just doesn't, okay? That's just the truth, the hard, cold hard facts right there. Lightning doesn't strike twice until it does. And then it strikes twice. But, you know, not usually. It doesn't. Okay, so I thought what we'd do is start on one extreme side and then wrap around all the way around and check out the new area. Now, if you guys don't know, if you didn't see my update video or you just haven't, like, you don't play in the center, you don't watch any videos in the center, there's a whole new center, like, expansion area, like, down below. There's, like, a new underworld area, and it's right down here. This is the beginning. I really like this beginning area right here just because I like the whole, like, waterfall area right there. That'd be a really cool place to, like, set up your base. Oh, God. Are you gonna go off? Okay, there we go. I'm experiencing a little bit of lag right now. We're having some problems with the server. It keeps crashing, and that's the reason why I haven't recorded that much on this guy. Why does he not let me ride him? Okay. Yeah, it keeps crashing, and then we're having, like, performance issues with it. I think it has to do with just all the mods. Like, I don't think Anunnaki, I don't know. Anunnaki has been, oh, God. Anyways, let's go ahead and explore. Now, this whole area over here is kind of cool. Like I said, I really like this area. I think it's pretty sweet. With the waterfalls, it'd be kind of a cool area to store all of your water creatures and just have your base in general. Like, this is a really nice area right here. And then it wraps around. What it does is actually wraps around from the snowbound here, which is up there. And it goes all the way around the map to the, Redwood Biome. And then underneath this area, there's like a whole ice crystal, like ice cave, ice fortress area, and it looks really, really sweet. This is actually a new area where a bunch of penguins spawn and that kind of stuff. But I explored this earlier, and I explored a lot of places, and I'm not sure if the scorched earth creatures are spawning properly, because I know Wright and them found a golem, but for some reason I didn't find any creatures around the map earlier. So if I can't find any creatures, I'm gonna have to do like a destroy wild dinos or whatever and see if any creatures spawn, because I really want to tame some of the new ones, especially the mantis. I want to try out the mantis for sure. Okay, so we're entering the beautiful ice cave here. As you can see, there's some beautiful ice, blue ice crystals up on the wall. And if we keep going this way, we will encounter the amazing ice fortress. Now, the ice fortress does look cool. It's very blindingly light. But there's like, I actually expected it to be the entrance. Oh, God, I shouldn't jump down here. Yeah, I shouldn't have jumped down here. I actually expected it to be the entrance to like maybe like a cave or a dungeon or something, but I couldn't find anything. I'm not sure. I guess it's just a straight up ice fortress area or whatever. We got some waterfalls that go off the map here. Okay, so we made it up to the ice fortress here. Yeah, look at it. It's like super blindingly light, but it definitely looks really, really cool. It's like some kind of an ancient race of like frost giants lived here or something, and they carved everything out of ice. Which seems like, it doesn't seem like they wanted to future-proof it that much, because, I mean, ice eventually melts. So, you know, this has an expiration date at some point. But, yeah, this whole area is cool. There's not, like, anything in it. It's just kind of basically for looks. But it definitely looks really, really sweet. I'm not sure if you can build it on it either. I haven't tried. You might not be able to build on it. It might have, like, some kind of weird... No, you probably can, because you can build in the ruins in where German's old base was. So, yeah, you could probably build on it. But yeah, this whole area is definitely really, really cool. Looks like this used to be like a giant ice bridge. I wonder where it went. Okay, so we're going to continue wrapping around this way. And there's a nice cool like flat area down here that would be kind of cool to build. You could like block off between the two hills right there. I'm pointing where my head is right now, the very tip of my head. Like from right there to like right there, you could block that off. Cool little flat area. Pretty big flat area, actually. Let's go ahead and jump down here. Yep. Yes, there we go. And then this whole area here just is really, really neat. It's kind of different from anything else that has been done on the center. Well, I mean, I guess it's not really, because you have the whole underground world. But these giant ice crystals are cool, and then that ice fortress is really, really cool. Yeah, then whenever you leave the ice cave, it continues wrapping around the map. And then you're greeted by this other waterfall area. And this is actually underneath the land bridge right there. That's a land bridge that goes to the Redwood Biome. And then you have this whole awesome, like, waterfall area, which is sweet. Another waterfall area. This would be another cool place to kind of like build your base or whatever. And then I'm gonna continue. This is pretty much the whole new area here. I'm gonna continue exploring around. We're gonna try to find some scorched earth creatures. Okay, guys, we're back. So this is a few hours later. I've been searching on the map and dealing with trying to log in and out, because every time you log in and out, it takes about 30 to 40 minutes. It's pretty bad. Anyways, I cannot find any scorched creatures. So I don't know if we used to have a little thing and then it got deleted or what, but I'm going to go ahead and make a Scorched Shrine here. Yes, and then we shall place the shrine down. And then I guess what I'm going to do is I'm going to destroy wild dinos. And can I stick this up here? Yeah, okay, so this can actually go up here. I'm going to destroy wild dinos. And then we are going to, I guess the server will like go down. It'll kick me off. And then, oh, wow, I actually placed this completely screwed up. Let's see. So, Scorched Skins. Oh, make a set of champion skins from the Scorched Earth. Okay. Does that make... Oh, you have to... Okay, you have to kill the Manticore and you get, like, all the skins. That's kind of cool. Scorched Build, Scorched Gear. Make a set of gear and saddle blueprints from the Scorched Earth. And Scorched Sand. Gives raw and preserving sand. That is very strange. Do we not get, like, normal recipes or something? I'm not even sure where... the things would be like, let's just look up Adobe. Like Adobe? No. Okay. So well, oh, actually, wait a second. It's not showing it in here. Let's do this. Boom. Oh, how do we get this though? I don't know. Anyways, I guess it's through here. But we place down the shrine. So I'm going to do a nice, beautiful destroy wild dinos. Cheat, destroy wild dinos, and okay. Yeah, the server's lagging. So yeah, it's gonna kick me off. I'll see you guys probably here in about an hour, because that's probably how long, maybe an hour and a half, because that's probably how long it's going to take the server to do that. It's like all these mods like completely just screw everything up, man. Like the server has just got like worse and worse over time, and it has to just do with all these mods. Okay, guys, we're back. So what we want to do is I still have not found any Scorched Earth creatures, but I have made a Scorched Earth shrine. And this should allow the spawning. Now, we should have already had this on the server, so I'm not sure if maybe the server got reverted back to, like, before we had the shrine or something. But I've made a shrine. I'm going to see if that actually fixes spawning. And if you notice, you can actually craft. You get a set of blueprints from Scorched Earth by crafting these guys right here. So we're going to try to do that. But we need some specialized items. We need clay and all that kind of stuff. So I was thinking, why don't we go ahead and make a, I think it's called a chemistry bench. Is that what it's called? Let's go and just look this up. Let's see, bench. We need metal and we need spark powder. I'm pretty sure we have both of those. Let's go ahead and check it out. We do somewhere. I know we have metal and yeah, we got metal. Now we just need spark powder. And of course, we have a bunch of spark powder inside of our bolt grinder here. So let's go and stick that inside of this guy and we shall make the thing that we need. Now, actually, this bolt grinder can probably make the thing that we need. If I like set it down and like actually, you might as well try that, right? But, yeah, let's pick this up. Okay, pick up bolt grinder. Okay, this is probably a much better approach anyways. Let's go ahead and grab all that stuff. And then let me take the bolt grinder, and we shall set you back down, good sir, and it shall be beautiful. Are you not going to, okay, you're obviously in the way, because you're really fat. Okay, yep, there we go. We'll set that guy down, and then we need this guy to get the other guy to work. You know, a lot of guys in the equation here that acquires everything to work. Anyways, okay, so it looks, oh yeah, the dev kit hasn't been updated yet, so none of that stuff probably works. So yeah, we do need the chemistry bench. Where did I stick the chemistry bench? Of course, I haven't made the chemistry bench yet, so let's go ahead and craft this guy. Also, I'm running low on sleep right now, so I might be a little derpy. Also, I forgot to mention, this is a couple days later, like 3 or 4 days later than the previous clips. So let's go ahead and grab this guy. Do we have power over here? I'm not sure if we have power over here, actually. So before we get wild, let's go ahead and stick this guy somewhere that he's going to be useful. Like right here in this exact location right there. Boom. I know Nightwing is currently stuck behind him, but that's perfectly all right. So it looks like we cannot make stuff. Is this because... You know what? Let's go ahead. Let's do Scorched Earth. Okay. Looks like it's not letting me learn anything. Okay, so how are we supposed to do the engrams like clay? I need to be able to learn clay, right? What about this? Clay? Oh, okay. Okay, Scorched Shrine. Okay. We need to find... Let's find where clay is, and then I'm going to see if I can learn... Okay. Wait. No, let's get rid of that right there. Because it's all a part of the mod, right? So we need to learn everything that's a part of the mod, I guess. Okay, so we got some stuff right here. Some giant stone hatch frames. That seems apparent. Okay, more hatch frames. That also seems apparent. Night vision goggles. There we go. Then, I mean, I kind of want a flamethrower. Imagine, like, a celestial flamethrower at, like, 700%. That thing is going to destroy, absolutely murder, absolutely everything in its path. And it's going to be glorious. So, let me continue scrolling, and we're going to find some cool stuff here. Okay, cactus sap, sand. okay? I'm not sure how we get sand, actually. Plant species Y, deathworm horn. Use deathworm horns. Wait, can you, do you craft these? Wait, do you craft the horns? Why are they in grams? Okay, so we learned scorch gear. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, we've learned all that. Maybe you craft all the stuff inside of the thing. We'll have to go back and check it out here in a second. Let me learn everything. Okay, so these are all modded items. Those are all modded items. So it can't... Actually, no, it can be. I don't know. Whatever, it doesn't matter. Okay, we're going to come back over here. Okay, let's come over this way. And then let's check this guy out. Boom. Yeah, okay, so we can do everything. So sand. For sand, we need spark powder and cementing paste. And for clay, we need sand and keratin. Okay, so looks like they haven't made it where you can actually get it naturally. And then what about horns? Oh, you actually craft horns. Okay, so you need sap, keratin, and raw salt. Unfortunately, we don't really have a way to get sap, I don't think. Sap, okay. Spark powder and cementing paste. So I guess... Does that mean they don't spawn? That's strange if they don't spawn, the death worms. Let me work on this for a while, and I will be back. Okay, so we've been crafting a bunch of stuff here. I'm going to go ahead and stick a bunch of this stuff in here. I think we finally have everything we need to almost get everything. The only thing we're missing is sand. But, oh, that's because we're making some clay. Well, we'll have some sand here in a second. But I'm going to go ahead and craft, I guess, this. This is going to give us all the blueprints we need. Okay, boom, yes. And then we shall get this as well. And then I don't have any, oh, no, yeah, we need sand for that. And then plant Y seed. So we'll go ahead and grow that as well, because that seems kind of useful. We'll be able to do plant species Y and get a bunch of the traps, and that'd be kind of cool. And then I guess the only thing we need for this is salt and sap. Now, I don't know how to get salt. There's not an engram or a way to craft salt that I can see right here. And I don't have a way to get sap at the moment. There's no, like, sap seed or whatever. So I'm not exactly sure. We might have to actually get some redwoods, put some taps on them, and that kind of stuff. So that could be some future plans. And I guess I'm going to let all the stuff craft, and we shall be right back after it does. Okay, so we're about to see exactly what this does. Okay, yeah, so it just gives you the blueprints directly. Okay, so we got a common rock golem saddle. Oh, okay, this is cool. So all the stuff is directly in here. And then can we craft it directly in here? Okay, so we can just keep the blueprints just right here, which is cool. So it looks like we have access to all of the blueprints. Whips, homing rockets, flamethrowers. We want to make that for sure. We need polymer and electronics for that. And yeah, we just got blueprints for everything. Also, I'm going to grab the plant species Y seed. Also, raw salt? What? Wait, what? What? What is this? Is this the recipe? Okay. Yeah, this is, okay. Yeah, that's the recipe right there. So we have a way to get salt. Okay, that's a little confusing, I feel like. But, you know, it still makes sense, kind of. Possibly, not really. So the only thing we're missing is sap to make everything else. So we need sap to make repellent. Then we need, I guess, sap to make deathworm horns so we can tame mantises. That completely makes sense. So it's a good thing that we didn't actually find any mantises or any creatures anyways. Well, I mean, other creatures would have been fine, right? But, I mean, I guess the mantis wouldn't have been. Taming a golem would be kind of cool as well. But yeah, looks like we got plenty. Oh, this stuff. Wait. This stuff, it goes bad. Okay. Well, what do we need for a preserving jar? We might as well make a few of those, right? Or vessels, I should say. So clay, wood, and thatch. Ah, yes, girl. We can make more salt. I'm just really interested in this stuff right here. I don't care about preserving salt. You suck, salt. Okay. Well, I guess we're pretty much good, guys. We're freaking good, except for that guy. But we can make everything else. I mean, we need to kill the manticore for that. But I want to make the flamethrower, and I want to upgrade the flamethrower. So, and then I guess we need stuff to use for the flamethrower, right? Also, a chainsaw would be cool. Oh, yeah, okay, let's get polymer electronics real quick. Let's get polymer electronics. Let's make the chainsaw, and let's make the flamethrower, and let's upgrade the crap out of both those guys. So we got electronics. We got polymer. Beautiful. That is very beautiful right there. Let us put both of these in here, and then we shall do this. Let's go ahead and, yep, crafters, and then crafters, yep. Okay, so we got a flamethrower, we got a chainsaw, it's time to upgrade both. Oh, cluster grenades would be really sick too, that would be awesome. Flamethrower, so this needs propellant and gasoline. We got plenty of gasoline, we just need the propellant. So we need sap for sure. Let me figure out a way to get sap. I mean, I guess, I wish there was an easy way to get sap. But I guess we're going to have to do it the old-fashioned way. We're just going to have to do it the old-fashioned way. Also, I'm going to plant this plant species Y seed. Let's go up here and plant it, and we'll see how fast it grows. I bet it grows pretty fast. Yeah, what are you staring at? Okay, so we made it all the way up to the top here. Let us stick the plant species wide right here. Turn on. Why were you off? Are these... Okay, no? Okay. Plant species wide, yeah. Plant this in a viable large crop plot to grow a frightening-looking defensive plant, which will shoot poisonous spores at its interlopers. Or at any interlopers. I think that's the wrong description, actually. But I'm sure this will grow slowly over time. That'll be amazing. So, yeah. Let me play with some more stuff. I need to figure out an easy way to get sap. I figured there'd be an easy way, like, right here, but I guess not. I was hoping for a sap seed. I mean, the resource crops... A raptor chick, what are you doing, man? Like, what are you doing? I mean, it's there's no sap seed, so... I'm just joking, I'm kidding. You don't have to make a sap seed, but, I mean, it would be awesome if you made a sap seed, so I'm just putting that out there. You know, if you guys want to spam Raptor Chick with sap seed requests, then that would be all right. You know, like, I'm not prohibiting you guys from doing that or anything. So, yeah, I mean, we'll just, I'll wait around until you guys, you know, spam her, you know. So, sap seeds, no big deal. Yep, sap seeds, dupe sap seeds, yep. In the meantime, let's go ahead and... Hey, you server? Hello? Hello, sir? Okay. Hi. In the meantime, let's try this again. Okay, hello. Okay, yes, hi. Let's grab some fiber. Let's grab some thatch. And then let us grab some wood. I think wood is right here. Yes. And we shall make the most ultimate redwood crafting table. Yes, go ahead and give this to me. Okay, beautiful. And then we shall stick the redwood crafting table just for right now. Like, right... Oh, okay. No. Let's stop that. Okay, we shall stick it, like, right here. Boom! Okay, and let us make a redwood. So, metal platform, okay. Snapple redwood tree. Can be placed and picked up. No HP with 4 snap points. Okay, metal, and then where is the cementing paste? Oh, by the way, guys, I'm from the U.S. I just like using weird accents and doing, like, weird noises with my mouth. You guys should know me in real life because I make far more weird noises in real life. I also do a lot more voices in real life. If you guys didn't know, Jim Carrey was, like, one of my inspirations growing up as a kid. And I went around doing all kinds of impersonations. I'm actually a lot more laid back in my videos than what I am in real life. I know that's surprising, but... I have a much crazier personality in real life, so that's all I do is, like, voices and all kinds of crazy stuff. Are you gonna... The server is, like, killing itself, right? Oh, this is beautiful. Okay. Let's, Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look at that. This is cool, I guess. That's a redwood tree right there, okay? And then let's grab some of these saps, sap taps. I just rhymed. Okay, guys, we're back. So we're running, we have a sap problem pretty much, right? Well, the best way to fix a sap problem is I just looked up some information on the wiki, and apparently each tree tap sap can collect up to about 20 over a real-life day, like between 1 and 3 real-life days or something, I don't know. German does have some sap, I'm going to steal some from him, but what we're going to do is to remedy this situation, we are going to place down like 200 tree saps throughout the redwood forest here, and just like, we will never have problems with tree sap ever again. So it looks like you can do about 4 per tree, it looks like, which is pretty good. Whoa. Okay, wait. Can you do multiples right there? How does that work? No, I'm not going to try that. I'm not going to test that out. But yeah, it looks like you can do about 4 per tree. So we are going to go freaking buck wild on all of these trees. I'm going to place down at least 100. At least 100 saps. And then, I mean, that'll be about 2,000. I mean, it's going to be kind of a pain in the balls to go around and collect all of it when I need it, but it's going to be worth it to kind of, like, preemptively plan and do this. Also, I realize I'm doing this in German's base, and he might not appreciate having, like, thousands of tree things everywhere, but you know what?
I don't care what he thinks. He's building on the meaty territory, okay? It's something. He's doing something that's illegal, and I'm going to get him for it. So this is his bedroom, right? So that's a nice little area. Kind of sparse, kind of Spartan. Well, except for down here. Well, no, I mean, it's more like a hunting lodge, I guess, really. A treehouse hunting lodge. Except for his bedroom, like is where his bed is sparse. Maybe he likes the nice clean look. He can lay down, look up at the stars or the trees, and it'll be beautiful. Anyways, I'm going to place down a bunch of these, and I'll be back. Okay, so we've stolen some sap from German here. I went and got some silica pearls from upstairs here, and I have made some Deathorn horns. So every time you craft one of these guys, I didn't realize, but it actually gives you 15 horns. So we got plenty of horns, enough to last a while anyways. And I guess let's just go ahead and make some propellant. I'm going to make 98 propellant. Then we're going to get some gasoline. And then we shall make some whatever that is that we need to for the flamethrower stuff. Okay, so we got gasoline. We got propellant. Can we make the stuff now? Let's see. Flamethrower ammo. Nice. Let's go ahead and craft 9 of these guys. I'm assuming it's going to craft more than one apiece. Oh, wow. It only crafts one apiece. Holy crap. Well, we got 9 so far. And then now what I want to do is I want to upgrade all the stuff. I have 6 quality buffs, so let's upgrade upgrade everything. I'm going to go ahead and take everything out of my – I don't want to try to upgrade my armor or anything. I don't want to, like, I guess fill up my inventory with a bunch of useless crap. So let's go ahead and throw all this stuff inside of my inventory. Boom. Yes, and then we shall use the quality buffs. Boom. And then do we get anything super amazing? Okay, so we got 300%. Nice. I will take it. And we got 400%. That's pretty good. I'll take that as well. So quality buff again. We got 100 and we got 300. And this is, okay, not better. We got 200 and then 350. That's a little bit better. Okay. Then this is, yeah, that's 400. Okay. Let's go ahead and use it again. I'm hoping to get 5. Oh, there we go. 500. And then this is 100. Okay. I'm hoping to get at least 500 or 600. That'd be sweet. So 300. Okay. And then 400. This is 600. Nice. Okay. And then one more, I guess 2 more times. 300 and then 200. Come on, baby. You got this. Get over 600. That'd be sweet. That would be absolutely. Wow. Was that the last one? No. Was that the last one? No. Okay, fine. That's good. I mean, we still got some great ones right here. So yeah, we're fully prepared. I think what I'm gonna do now is we are gonna fly around. The Scorched Earth creature should have had plenty of time to maybe spawn a little bit, and we're gonna see if we can find any of those guys. Oh, guys, that definitely did the trick, because we got a golem down here and we have a wyvern down here. Now the wyvern's like pink. What the heck? I feel like this is a poison wyvern too when it's pink. Holy crap. Rock elemental, okay, level 45. Poison wyvern, yeah, what level was this guy? This guy was level, are you gonna show me? So yeah, they are spawning, which is sweet. Now, eggs is a little tricky to get in this, I think. I think they spawn randomly in the wild, or they have a random chance of, like, being pooped out by the wyverns in the wild. I'm not exactly sure how it works. Because as you guys know, there's no, like, special, like, wyvern layers or anything like that. But we are getting creatures, which is awesome. So, I guess what we want to do is we want to either find an egg, a wyvern egg. We want to tame a very high-level rock golem, and they're going to be under the Anunnaki, like, spawning. So that means they can spawn up to level 600, or we want to find a mantis. So whichever one of those we find first is the one that we're going to tame, and it's going to be amazing. So I guess what happened was Riot and them built the thing, maybe. Or maybe German built the thing, I don't know. And then they got, like, reset or something. They didn't have the thing anymore, because everything seems to be spawning fine now, which is beautiful. Oh, there's actually another rock golem right here. What's up, man? You are level 125. Okay. So that's looking up. So I'm going to look around for a while, guys. Guys. Okay, this is almost like immediately afterwards. Okay, get off the Argentavis. Hurry. Get off the Argentavis. Okay. Oh my god, why is this so difficult? Just get off the Argentavis. Okay, get off the yep. Okay, now we're going to set flame to everything that's right here. Okay, you know, I mean, not quite as good of damage as I thought it was going to be, but you know, we're still roasting everything, which is absolutely glorious. Let's grab this egg. What level are you? You are level, I don't know what level you are, but let's see. Fertilized wyvern egg. This is a lightning egg. You are level, it doesn't say what the level is. What? Why? Okay, so I guess it's random? Bugs. Bugs, stop it, please, for the love of God, stop it. Okay, you know what, we need to bring out, okay, no, everything's dead. So you want to check all this stuff? Everything's completely dead. Oh, tiny experience potion, nice. Okay, oh my God, get off of me, bugs. Ah, for the love of God and all that is holy, you need to die. Okay, so we got an egg, right? Maybe we won't hatch this yet. We'll hold on to it, okay? We'll hold on to it. Yeah, because that's going to require a whole hatching process. And then maybe what we'll do is we'll find a bunch of eggs. We'll find like 10 eggs at once, and we'll hatch them all at the same time. Oh, we need milk too, so that means we need to knock out female wyverns. We'll do that next episode. We'll do that next episode. I'm actually kind of getting excited about playing modded, guys. We have some like goals and stuff to do, and it all involves the new Scorched stuff, Earth stuff, which is really awesome. Now, I just hope that these eggs are kind of high level. I also hope that he's enabled it so the wyverns can breed. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to, though. If it's just like Scorched, then they won't be able to breed at all. So, yeah, I'm going to continue looking around. What is that? Oh, that's a Pteranodon. Also, I think in the recent patch, they've added the Tapajara and then the Archaeopteryx to Scorched Earth. So that's something we can tame here pretty soon as well. That's going to be awesome. Oh, guys, I've spotted my first Morillotops here, or Camelosaurus. That's awesome. So I've seen the wyverns, I've seen wyvern eggs, I've seen the Morillotops, and then I've also seen the golems. No, oh, wait. Oh, there's a moth right here. Oh, look, it's a moth. Nice. And is that a, no, that's a Quetz. Oh, dude, awesome. So we got a moth. I guess, man, we're seeing everything except for the things that I actually want. Please let me find. I'm assuming things are still kind of spawning in, though. As creatures die, some of the new creatures will start spawning in. Also, apparently the Manticore, I think it spawns in naturally in the world, which is kind of nuts. that's really nuts. So maybe we'll try to kill the Manticore soon. Okay, here are the immediate goals. Like I said before, Mantis, get a bunch of wyvern eggs, hatch all the wyvern eggs, kill Manticore, and then I guess do some other cool stuff. I mean, like normal, I guess. But I think I can confirm at this point that alpha deathworms do spawn, and they spawn in very weird locations. Let's go and eat his body. Did he drop a sack? No, but we did get one deathworm horn. So I don't know if that was an alpha or a normal. I don't remember what it said, but they do spawn, which is cool. So you don't actually have to craft the horns. So that's very good information to know. And for some reason, I guess they don't have like the way the Dragon God mod, and I guess the way Peggy makes all of his mods or her mods is they just spawn randomly everywhere. So I guess there's no like biome spawning or anything. They can just spawn anywhere they want to. But it's kind of cool that we found a deathworm. That's actually really, really awesome. Okay, so I've encountered our first mantis on the lava island here, the Scorched Island. And it's only level 15, though. So not quite what we're looking for, but at least we know they do spawn. So that's very, very good. I think I've seen everything now. I've even seen the jug bugs everywhere, which is kind of cool. I didn't think the jug bugs were kind of worth like showing you guys. Oh, there's one right there. Yeah, so there we go. You can see him. But yeah, there's the oil and water variant. So yeah, everything spawns, it seems like, anyways. It seems like mantises are like the rarest things, though. I'm not sure if that's just because, I don't know, all the spawns aren't here yet or what. I'm not exactly sure, since we didn't destroy wild dinos. Or if it's just being weird. I have no idea. But I'm going to continue looking around. We're going to try to find one. See, one thing I haven't confirmed is if they spawn up to level 600 or not. I think the max, I haven't actually looked at all of the creatures we found, but I think the max I've seen so far is like level 125. So I'm not exactly sure. We're going to find out, though. Okay, guys, we're back. So I have found the highest level one so far. This one is level 140. So this is the highest one I've ever found, and I've seen quite a lot of them so far. Also, this one looks kind of cool. So, okay, he needs two. He needs two to tame him. He also looks definitely really cool. He's kind of like a blackish / darkish green color, which is nice. And his little underbutt here is like tannish. So, I mean, he looks decent. I think it'd be kind of cool to like paint him. So maybe we'll try to do that here at some point. I'm going to wait until we can actually feed him again, and then we're going to see what he's like with the lance and also with this guy. I'm kind of disappointed that he's only level 140, and I haven't seen anyone higher than this. Like, seriously, most of them have been like level 95 or 120, and the previous one before this that was the highest level was level 125. So I'm assuming they can spawn. It's just like they're so rare for me to find them that I'm just not getting lucky, I guess. I don't know. Or maybe they are limited by like level 150. But on the mod thing, it says if you have a difficulty mod, then they will spawn at those difficulties. So I don't know, guys. I'm not sure. But I'm going to wait until he does his thing. Oh, here we go, guys. Yes, there we go. Over level 200. So you guys know how on the Scorched Earth map, the vultures are like, and the mantises are like arch rivals. Well, on this map, it seems like mantises absolutely hate dire bears. They go after them. They ignore everything else except for dire bears. They despise dire bears, like 100%. It's crazy. Anyways, we got a mantis saddle, so let's go ahead and give them that. Actually, let's go ahead and do... Oh, wait, no, never mind. You got it. Let's go ahead and give you the lightsaber. Oh, heck yeah, guys. Look at this. It's so amazing. Oh, my God. He has dual light. Wait, wait. Is this... Let's unequip this. Wait, it doesn't render the colors? No, that sucks. Let's give you the lance as well, because the lance is going to be pretty sweet. Okay, let's give you the lance. Oh, heck yeah. Look at this. I bet he knocks out things like crazy. Okay, well, he's super fat right now. Actually, let's go ahead and give him... Well, no, let's... Okay, so I'm going to have to give him a little bit of weight just because he, like, does not like being like this at all. Okay, so we give him a little bit of weight, and let's just whack something. I just want to see what his base damage is with this, and I think what we're going to do is we're actually going to give him a instant level potion and then just make him, like, super, super OP. It's going to be great. Okay, what's up, kangaroo? What's up, man? And then... What, you can't swing it? No! All my hopes and dreams are not realized at all. Wait, okay, yeah, there we go. So by default, 2,600 damage. Oh, yes, he swings the lightsabers. That's so amazing. It's so amazing. Hell yeah. Okay, I have the auto clicker up. I'm going to give him the instant level potion here. And then we are going to max him out. 2,000 damage by default with 700% weapon damage. Now he has over 1 billion XP. And then we can give him 250 levels in HP. Yes. It's probably not going to be that much, actually. I'm guesstimating around 75,000. Okay, 70,000. Okay. And then melee damage. That's because he's such a low level. If he was like level 600, he'd be getting way more just because he'd be getting more per stat. But let's go ahead and do this. I'm guessing this is going to be around, I don't know. Okay. Okay, that's actually higher than I expected. Let's give him a little bit of stamina. Actually, let's go ahead and give him 250 levels in stamina just because he might need it. Okay. You know, that's actually plenty of stamina. Let's give him a little bit of weight. Okay. And then let's give him some movement speed, baby. Yeah. That was way too much. That was way too much movement speed before we level. That's actually not quite as fast as I... 68,000 damage. That is crazy. Imagine if this guy was like any higher level, or even like if it was a modded creature. That would be absolutely amazing. Let's go ahead and just boost up his weight some more, I guess. And you know what? We might as well just do some movement speed some more. Let's just get this up to like 1,200. Yeah, okay. 1,000. Yeah, not that bad. Not that bad, really. Oh my God, guys. Guys, this is a slayer of everything that is holy in the world. Like, this guy absolutely wrecks it. I mean, what's better than a mantis with lightsabers? Tell me. Like, there's nothing better. Oh, let's do the leap. I didn't even think about that, but doesn't this do like 4 times damage? Actually, no, it doesn't. Okay. I'm sure you guys are curious. So let's try it without the lightsaber, right? So let's do a sample attacker here. Okay, so 6,000 damage with the leap. And then the lightsabers make it way better. Now let's try the lance right here. Let's get our lance on, baby. Okay, let's Yeah, we can slay him. I bet this guy knocks out things like crazy. If only we had a good example or something to show him. Or something to like use him on. Oh, okay. Okay, how much Let's just see what it is. Okay, so it's over 8,000 torpor per swing. I'm going to guess it's probably around 20,000 torpor. It's probably a lot. I kind of want to... Maybe we'll get into the specifics of what it is exactly next episode. But I think for now, I know this has been short, fun time with the mantis, but I am extremely tired. I promise. We will do some extra super amazing fun time with the mantis next time. We'll test out like what his max torpor is and everything. It'll be great. I'm really excited about this, guys. And the Scorched Earth on the modded is going to be amazing. So I expect at least... I think we're all going to try to fight the thing soon. But I think what I might do is I might actually continue this on until we, you know, get full, full enjoyment out of the mod here, the Scorched Earth mod. So I'm guessing at least 5 more episodes, probably. I don't know. I'm not sure, really. But, you know, we'll see what happens. And then we have a whole new plan for an exciting new mod pack. And it's going to be me, Riot, German, and Thomny again. And then we're going to try to collaborate a lot more, kind of like what we did on Scorched Earth. But we're going to try to collaborate a lot more in the new mod pack. I think we'll be basing together because we're going to try to make it a more hardcore experience. And it's going to require more teamwork. So I'm really, really, really excited about that. And we're going to try to make it a smaller mod pack, too, to make it more enjoyable and also more stable. So instead of kind of like a kitchen sink pack with everything in it. Oh, my God. I don't know why I didn't expect this, but he can also, like, swing the swords under the water, too. Dude, this guy is amazing. Like, I love the Mantis so much. Dude, the Mantis is by far the coolest creature to be in art. This is awesome. Also, we can upgrade a saddle, too, and make him super amazing. And I really hope they do some Mantis costumes in the future. Imagine, like, all the cool stuff they could do with the costumes. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in the next one.